Mixed martial arts as we know it today is a relatively new sport and has established itself globally in a pretty short amount of time. MMA has been popular in countries like the United States and Brazil for several decades now, but for other countries like China, it has only just recently started to gain a foothold. I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to give my take on some of the best talent China has to offer the sport. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Fight Dialogue. My name is Tim. So I'm going to give my picks for the three best Chinese fighters to ever do it in MMA. And as with the previous installments in the series, this is just an opinion-based list, so take it with a grain of salt. Also, seeing as how I do not speak any of the 30 different languages spoken in China, expect my pronunciation of names and places to be a little less than perfect. We all know that China is a big country with over a billion people. Its capital is Beijing, and it is the birthplace of dozens of martial arts, some of which make up the sport of MMA today. As I mentioned before, MMA has really started to heat up in China recently, and a big part of that has been due to ONE FC, which is the organization that the number three fighter on this list fights for. Her name is Zhang Jingnan, and she is currently the ONE FC strawweight champ. Zhang was born in the Shandong province of China, and she has a pro record of 14 wins with 2 losses, and most of her wins have come by way of knockout. Jingnan is known for having a ton of power, and she likes to employ a high-pressure strategy, where she overwhelms her foes with ferocious combinations. She's had 2 very noteworthy fights with the current atomweight champ, Angela Lee, the first of which was a TKO win to retain the strawweight title, but she lost the second fight after moving back down to atomweight. I expect to see a rubber match between these two ladies and many more exciting fights to come. Next on the list is Li Jingliang, who is from the northwestern Xinjiang region of the country. He's a welterweight in the UFC with a record of 17-6. All 17 of his wins came by way of submission or knockout. All but one of his losses came by way of decision. Not for nothing, but when you fight in the most talent-rich division of the most talent-rich organization in the world, and if you have that kind of record, it's going to impress the hell out of me. He's known for being well-rounded and for using flashier techniques when he gets the opportunity. He has notable wins against Diego Lima, Luke Jumo, a fight of the night win over Frank Camacho, and many other highlight reel finishes. Despite his recent loss to Neil Magny, I feel like Lee has yet to even hit his prime and will continue to do well in the sport. Number one on this list, as you may have guessed already, is the current UFC strawweight champ, Weili Zhang. Born in the city of Handan and fighting out of Beijing, she lost her first pro MMA fight, but then went on an incredible 21 fight unbeaten streak that she continues as of this recording. She's known for her unrelenting pace, well-rounded game, and lightning fast speed. Zhang slowly but surely worked her way up through the ranks of the UFC, and despite her impressive record, she somewhat unexpectedly earned her title shot against Jessica Andrade. She destroyed Andrade in 42 seconds and earned the upset win as well as the belt. Since then, she fought in what was perhaps the greatest women's MMA fight in history in a winning effort against the best female strawweight champ ever, Joanna Jędrzejczyk. She very well may have stolen that moniker from Joanna and is without a doubt the best Chinese MMA fighter I have ever seen. I plan on doing more videos like this in the future, so please give me whatever suggestions you have in the comments below. Make sure you guys like and subscribe, and thanks a lot for watching, guys. Take care.